This is my mother. Her name is Sandy Crisp. She was born as the sun set at the top of a Ferris wheel here in Southern California. The doctors diagnosed her with polio. They crushed her limbs, cracked bones in her body, breaking her wrist. They distorted her spine. She says it takes work to achieve perfect form. Have you ever seen a miracle dress this well? I doubt it. She's a born entertainer, a song and dance show woman, a fox who has had to outperform tough luck, star-crossed fate, and the law. She got arrested one night after she was caught hooking the entire Glendale College football team, 36 men, one by one, after a winning game. She spent the night in a local jail where she sang Judy Garland Somewhere Over the Rainbow over the intercom to prisoners until they all fell asleep. Behind her curtain of glamour, we live very regular lives. We listen to Donny Osmond every Christmas morning. We dance the waltz in the street when it rains. We eat at the Red Lobster every morning after church. We scream at the mailman for driving too fast down the street. Like all other people, we crack jokes, we pull pranks, we howl at the moon, and we laugh ourselves to sleep. My mother wants to unite the entire world through tap dancing. I've seen her do unbelievable things. She could rise and stomp her feet at lightning speed. Even on crutches, her movement was graceful, and she could jeté like a gazelle. She used to be able to balance a chair on her chin some time ago. She was a tap dancing heartbreaker, and would use her moves to stop men dead like deer in their tracks. If Jesus was able to walk on water, my mother could pirouette. We dream that on Judgment Day, God will come back and judge us only on our tap dancing. The entire world would erupt in a great big divine tap dance. People from each continent would tap their feet so fast that they'd begin to hover off the ground, imploding planet Earth and blasting billions of tapestries straight into orbit. It'd be the greatest dance the world has ever seen. My mother's my favorite fairy tale princess. She lived in a foster home with 14 other disabled boys. They drank Jack Daniels and played cards and took care of a pack of show dogs, bathing them and brushing their fur each week. Golden Retriever took to her especially. She called him Bandit. He'd steal daisies from the garden and smiled all pervy and big like the Cheshire Cat. The boys were looked after by a wicked foster mother. Her name was Grandel. She would make them drink spoiled milk if they didn't say their prayers. On New Year's Eve, Sandy played a game of strip poker with one of her foster brothers, Johnny Mays. She lost the hand and took her pants off. Grandel opened the door and saw Sandy in her underwear. She smacked her hard in the face and tossed her crutches across the room. Sandy sat there crying, unable to move or get up. Bandit hobbled into the room, licked away her tears, and scooted her crutches back to her. Some months later, Johnny ended up having an upper respiratory problem which caused him to stop breathing during the night. Sandy called out for help and tried to do compression on his chest, but by the time the ambulance came, he passed away. She limped into the street trying to run after him. And when her legs gave out, she tried to fly. She flapped her crutches, hoping to reach him. She spent every day in her room whirling her crutches, hoping to flutter off the ground. Ma dedicated Donny Osmond's puppy love to Johnny and Bandit. She performed it in nightclubs, bus stations, and airports. A tribute to the dream that flew away.
Oh, I guess they'll never know.
My mother's a sex symbol on six wheels. Her rising fame and success as an actress and entertainer helped her to find her man of choice. Macho, Latino, round tush, and built with calves like John Wayne. These men would sail in and out of her life like she was a five-star seafood buffet. Every hustler and hard body wanted a piece of my mother, and she delivered. She charmed her customers when she used to bust tables working at the Okie Dog, and seduced valet boys who would line up and try and park her power chair, like this gentleman right here. Or this truck stop Marlon Brando. She'd fall in love 24 hours a day. Every set was hot, and there was enough action to guarantee overtime. She never discriminated against these co-stars. She'd take a bad boy if he'd sweep her off her feet. Or even the sleazy accountant, if he minded his manners. Life was beautiful, and every sunrise ended with a martini shot.
I'm the happiest motherfucking accountant. I don't give a fuck if the world knows about it. Because I'm so fucking happy. Yeah.
I hope all the fans are happy now that the old bitch is married. Because now, no more free tit shots.
She eased on the gas when she met her ex-husband Rocky one night tap dancing at the Spotlight Bar, the oldest queer bar in Hollywood. They immediately fell in love. He looked like a young Eric Estrada. My mother has a sweet soul. Beneath her wild angora fur is a gentle heart. A heart that wants to be adored like everybody else. That beyond millions of fans there'd be one leading man to carry her off stage and take her home. She saw that in Rocky. And in an instant, it was like they were transported. Dancing on the beach in Havana. Drunk off pina coladas. He gazed into her eyes. She plied. And he kissed her as the waves crashed. My mother's the goddess bunny, and her misfortunes are merely just ticks behind her bunny ears. She can play the dainty starlet you see on screen, because she's rehearsed for years with the chaos of life. She survived polio, hardcore malpractice, broken bones, violent rape, and assaults. She runs lines with doctors while they treat her UTIs, and practices her songs with nurses while they bathe her. Rocky later admitted to giving my mother the HIV virus. Before they got together, he was gang raped in prison and penetrated by a man with AIDS. He passed away and left my mother to fend for herself in the spotlight alone. But these ill-fated truths don't describe the glistening spirit that truly is the goddess. My mother's an A-list celebrity in a black velvet dress, a fairy tale princess who could knock out Cinderella's teeth in a street fight. She has the guts and the brawn that some Vegas prize fighters don't. She's a song and dance diva who's made foster homes, hospitals, and bus stops her Broadway stage. My mother is living an illustrious life. I met her when I was just a teenager, when I was just a fan. Starstruck because I'd watch her tap dance when I was just a child, and she was greater to me than the Wizard of Oz. I was a loser, and she was my heroine. We've gone on countless adventures. We've belted love ballads to garbage men and liquor store clerks. We've run people over with her chair wasted in the streets. We ran for office in the city of Inglewood, and we lost. I've spit-shined her ruby-red slippers, and I'm still on the hunt to find her a greased-up Mario Lopez to carry her down the aisle. It has been 3 years now since the goddess bunny has placed me on her will as her only son, and I'm still so starstruck. I love you, Mom. You make me feel dazzling and tough. You make me feel free and unashamed. And if I'm ever sad, you'll run over my toes to remind me that love is so much greater than the suffering. That your balls are bigger than mine. That wild is our nature, and we don't need legs to dance. And the reason why we can't fly over the mountain is because we're headed straight towards the sun in the sky. Because shooting stars are really just wheelchairs that went off the rails. I love you, Mom. Far beyond death. Because you make me feel like we're never gonna die.